everybody. Happy Friday. Okay, so, I have started drinking again and smoking cigarettes. Not good. And combined with the constant vineyard purging, I am a sinking ship. So, I decided to have a bottle of wine on Sunday. And I haven't started drinking since I've taken the medication because I didn't, you know, my fear was missing. But apparently, nothing happened, so. Yeah, I drank. It was nice. I love drinking. I miss drinking because there's a lot of chatter in my head. There's a lot of constant going and going and going and back and forth. And it's just like a power struggle. Yes, I sound crazy. But there's something that happens with drinking that drinking is bad, but in a way it's good because drinking is liberating. It's very numbing to me, and it allows me to have a couple hours, like a couple hours break from the eating disorder, while I'm able to just focus on the feeling of numbness and you know, the delirium of the alcohol. So Monday I decided to continue this little party of mine and drank again. Now this week has been a very odd and tiring week with me and my husband because he is he's throwing a lot of temper tantrums and kind of getting mad for no reason, or he has his reasons but he doesn't, you know, disclose them with me. So I live in a little shoebox, and having this big personality be very angry with you and you know, isolate himself and my daughter in another room, and you know, I'm the odd man out, and you know, I'm being treated like I've committed cardinal sins or some shit, and you know, it's pretty awful. And I'm already in the bitching and purging cycle, which I can't seem to get out of right now. And usually when I binge and purge a lot, binge and purging, you know, is my own form of torture. It's my own punishment, you know. So imagine feeling like crap and then having an additional layer of shit mounted on top of you. It just makes the binge and purging more and more. So yeah. So I'm going to try to tell you as much as I can about this week, because the truth is that when I get into that binge and purging cycle, I tend to kind of close up and get in my own little bubble, and hence I haven't been vlogging as much, and I'm sorry for that. So yeah, he and I have been arguing a lot, and I suspected as much that it was because I was gonna start getting my child support payment soon. And He's just very, he's just so stubborn, you know. He's very stubborn. So, Monday we ended up arguing. And it was a stupid argument because I was, 1 minute he was talking to me, and then he's drinking, I'm drinking, I'm on the computer, I'm chatting, I'm just doing my own thing. And in the morning, he's like totally copping an attitude, and I just don't understand. And it just so happens that Tuesday I had my new shrink appointment. Oh boy, let's talk about that. Okay, my new shrink. Wow. Now, my new shrink is not like my old shrink, let me tell you. I miss my old shrink. But, they're very different. I miss my old shrink in the way of being comfortable and kind of, you know, I don't want to bash the lady because I love her dearly, you know, she has a place in my heart. But I felt like we weren't getting anywhere, even though we were making like teeny tiny little progress, but we weren't really chipping away at anything, you know. We were kind of, it's essentially like trying to bring down a wall with a little toy mallet. I mean, you're not going to really get anywhere. So even though I was seeing my other shrink and, you know, things were good and talking and stuff, I felt like we sometimes I would question to myself, like, how much longer do I have to be here? You know, like, I don't want to be here for years, just like constant, you know, I want to get things resolved, you know, I want to have closure. And, but sometimes I felt like that with her. But it was nice, the atmosphere, because, you know, she made me very comfortable and I was very open with her. And, you know, I appreciate that. Now, this new shrink, I was very nervous and I was already in a crap mood from the drinking. I had a hangover. And plus, you know, my husband is pissy attitude. And, but I went there and I saw her. Her office is very comfortable. It's very, very comfortable. Her office smells like vanilla and lavender, which I love. And, you know, there's a lot of pictures everywhere, and it's very humble, you know. It's like a little cave, you know. I would say man cave, but this is like a shrink cave, I suppose. So, she... Okay, so we're sitting down, right? And just like I'm talking to you like this in the camera, okay, that's how our session was. I'm not used to having someone so close to me, you know, especially if you're a stranger, like, I don't like that. So yeah, she was like kind of in my space a little bit, and, you know, we're face to face. I'm not used to that. Like with my other shrink, yeah, we were kind of face to face, but it was like, we had like a buffer, you know, we had like a desk between us, or... sometimes I'll be in a different chair, as you know, in an angular position to her, and like I'm not ready for face to face, and you were in my space a little bit, you know. So, but that's how the session was. I was not expecting that. I mean, as soon as I stepped in her office, the setup of the thing. I mean, it's like walking into the room where the electric chair or the gas chamber is. I mean, it's like boom, it's like right there. So that's how essentially it was. I walk into her office and there are the two chairs. We look like some shit out of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Like, we were just like face to face. So it's a little intimidating. Also, what's intimidating is that she has a video camera in her office and she likes to tape sessions. Now, I imagine that I was not being taped. I imagine that I would at least like to be asked permission to tape a session and stuff. So, but yeah, she does have a video camera there. She is a hypnotherapist as well, so I imagine that is why the video camera is present. She probably, you know, when you regress a lot of things, she probably, you know, gets it out of you and tapes the sessions and stuff. So I imagine that's what that is. Now, she, you know, was just like a basically get to know you. She asked me straight up, what do you want to get out of this therapy? Which is what my other shrink didn't ask me, really. And you know, I let her know my goals, the things I wanted to do. So I decided to be incredibly, brutally honest with her. Minus the eating disorder, which I'm not ready for yet. Brutally honest concerning my husband, because I was not so honest with my other shrink, with some things with my husband, because I feel like having him here with me, even though we're not together, I just feel like really pathetic, you know, like majority of my family doesn't talk to me because of him, you know. I don't know, they all expect me to just like kick him to the curb and stuff and like be this hard person. That's not me. I'm not like that. I can't just turn my back and not care, you know. Even though you can treat me like dirt, you know, that's just me. I care. I do. And I like forgiveness and I like forgiving people. But like I said before, I can't forgive him until he gives me space. I can forgive anybody, but I need a little break. I need time to process things, deal with things. So, but with my old shrink, I wasn't really upfront all the time with him, things concerning him, because I was really embarrassed. So I decided with this shrink that I was not going to do that. I was going to be incredibly honest, because that's the only way that I'm going to get something out of it. So I told her everything. I told her all my traumas, all everything that has led me to this very broken down person that's is talking in front of you right now. And she tells me that she's gonna help me. She's gonna help me cope, because apparently my coping skills suck. which I'm like incredibly surprised. But yeah, my coping skills suck, and she's gonna help me cope, and she's gonna help me kind of deal with things one thing at a time. So that's good. Now, I don't know why my weight came up in the conversation. Honestly, I couldn't. It was like a surprise. It was a really big surprise. I told her that I lost weight. Yeah, sure. And then the only picture I had of my before weight is on my driver's license, which no one will ever see unless you're the damn cop pulling me over, and or a few government officials, or a doctor in this case. And so she saw my picture and she's like, holy shit. And she just could not believe in the span of like a year or so, you know, I've lost 100 and something pounds. And so she started to kind of poke a little bit concerning, like, what am I really doing to lose weight? I don't know. I didn't like this conversation at all. If I could freaking run out the room, I would have. She just was like, what do you do? And I told her, look, you know, I exercise, which is true. I count calories, which is true. And, you know, that's what I do. I sometimes don't eat, which is true. And, you know, I didn't mention the binging and purging. I didn't mention that, you know, all this other shit. But she kind of kept digging at it. She's like, yeah, but do you find yourself not eating more than eating? And also, do you find yourself sometimes eating and then getting sick afterwards? Or, you know, like, she kept on, like, tiptoeing around the thing. And it's just our first session, so I imagine she's not going to let up on this. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to play stupid. And I'm pretty good at that. And so I'm going to go ahead and be like, I don't know what anorexia is, and I've never heard of bulimia, and I don't know what an eating disorder entails, and so that's what I'm gonna have to do, and hope that she buys my bullshit, and yeah. But other than that, the session was okay. You know, I feel I did have to inform her all over again about the history. She didn't have my prior history with my shrink and stuff, so I had to start all over again from scratch. I thought it would piss me off more, but it actually didn't, so it's okay. Now, Wednesday was the Spanish fair, the Hispanic Heritage Fair that I was supposed to volunteer at. I was supposed to make food for the festival. Now, I don't have an oven and a stove yet. The maintenance man, surprise, surprise, was not bothered. Now, luckily, I'm one of those people who is very friendly with all my neighbors. They know me, they know my kid, and I'm constantly doing favors for them, whether it be go to the store and do groceries for them, or bring my own groceries and give it to them, or take their trash out, or make their calls, or, I mean, the list can go on. I'm basically, that's just me. So, because they're all old, and I just think of my parents, and I just be like, you know, I would love for someone, if they were still alive and my parents were living somewhere or whatever, you know, like, I would love someone to do that for them, you know, if I was not living with them or incapable, you know. So, you know, that's what I do what I do. So, luckily, that pays off, because I had to cook all this food, and I didn't really want to, whatchamacallit, go to the school and volunteer passing out and all that crap that they wanted me to do. So I decided to make all the food. Now, I have no oven, I have no stove. Luckily, my neighbors, I was going from the second floor to the third floor using various stoves, and I had a lot of, I was multitasking really, really, really good. And one of them was so generous enough to give me a hot plate, which is very sweet, but my God, a hot plate. Hot plate takes so long. I think I can't even boil water. Like, I know boiling water takes a while, but like, this takes a long time, you know? So, I made the food. My evil husband, because he's still being very bitchy, decided to take the food to the school, and he was copping an attitude. We were supposed to go to the festival at night. But apparently the way his attitude was going, he really made me angry, upset. I mean, my God. So we were not gonna go. I think my husband is bipolar, honestly. My God, either that or freaking multiple personality disorders, because the man just like a light switch. All of a sudden he's apologizing, he's buying me booze, he's freaking, you know, like, it's changing his tune, and it's so exhausting. So, yeah, you're buying, I'm gonna take it. So, I got really, really, really disgustingly drunk Wednesday night. I drank 2 whole bottles of wine at 10% alcohol each on an empty stomach, and yeah. So, yesterday I felt like I was dying. I got up in the morning, he took my daughter, my daughter didn't have school yesterday. Everything worked out. And my God, I was in such pain. I was so hungover that it hurt. I thought I was dying, seriously. I felt so nauseous. I spent half the morning yakking in the toilet. And it was nothing but alcohol. My God. I just felt so awful. I had the shakes. My body was just shaking. And I was cold, I was sweaty, all these things. I'm like, do I have alcohol poisoning? I was debating whether to go to the emergency room or not, and then what am I gonna say, you know? So, but finally I yacked enough, and my husband had to go to work, so he decided to, you know, leave me with crackers and ginger ale and Gatorade and vamoose out of here. So I just did that. Yesterday I spent the day eating crackers and fruit and like drinking, and that's what I did. So I felt better. My daughter decided that she wanted to do a puzzle, a 200 piece puzzle yesterday, and I half did it, and then you know, it started to get late and she had school today, so I had to stop. But I really wanted to finish it because I kind of get OCD when it comes to stuff like that. Like, I don't like leaving stuff half done or undone or whatever, so I like to finish things. I don't like to start stuff and not finish. So, yeah, but I'm gonna finish it today, you best believe. So, yeah, today I feel really sick. My stomach hurts really, really bad, and I'm so bloated, I feel like crying. My digestion is really, really bad. I officially cannot digest food. And it makes me so sad because I feel like I don't have a chance, you know, like if I ever wanted to just start eating again, you know, just, I don't know what to do. I don't want to end up in the hospital with a fucking feeding tube in me, you know. So I am really in a lot of discomfort right now. But I'm gonna work out, and I don't know, drink Alka-Seltzer or some shit. I don't know what I can do. And it's not like I ate a bunch of shit. I just ate like this stuff, and it's just so sad. And I bet you it's just sitting in me, rotting away, because my body is not gonna digest it. My body doesn't know what to do with it, and it's like poison right now in my stomach. So, but yeah, So yeah, just been busy and purging still. I haven't yet today, but I feel really bad. I may end up busy and purging to see if I could alleviate something. And yeah, I went to check my mail and I got my first child support payment. Hooray. I'm happy about that. My husband had plans for my money on Wednesday night, apparently. I was really drunk. He said that I bitched him out so bad that he went straight to sleep. I don't remember that, but, you know, basically he wanted me with my money to pay for the insurance and the car and all that stuff, so. I mean, I would do it, but, like, what is the point of him being around? I don't get it. So, I don't know. The money's there. Let's see what happens. I think another fight before the week is over. And, yeah, I got my daughter from school. Already, I got food made for her already, so she's right now watching Diego and Dora, my God. And she made me this today. They were supposed to draw the thing that's is scary to them on Halloween, so she decided to draw a pumpkin. Now, the pumpkin apparently is eating everybody. Like, this is me, my husband, and the pumpkin's stomach. I don't know if you can see that. And then this is her. The pumpkin is turning her into a pumpkin. And then I asked her, what is this thing over here? And she said that that's a baby witch. And then this is our apartment, and that's the full moon. Apparently the pumpkin on the full moon goes ballistic and wants to devour people. So happy Halloween indeed. I can't wait. Tomorrow's October 1st. I love October. I'm so happy for that. So I don't know. What else can I tell you guys? The boy is straight. My baby's at work right now. And I'll talk to him later, hopefully. Things are cool with us still. And I don't know what else I can tell you. I think that's it. I'm really tired. I don't know what I'm going to do with myself right now. So I hope you all are well. Or doing better than me, at least. And we'll talk again tomorrow, guys. So I'm going to go now. So bye, everybody.